Hi, my name's Tom Meetzel. I'm a licensed real estate broker in the state of Wisconsin. I'm also a licensed realtor in the state of Nevada. I do real estate investment. We do coaching. We basically help new investors get started in their first couple properties. And one of the things we're going to talk about today is what a new investor needs to be looking for on their first couple of purchases. One of the first things you're going to want to do as a new investor is plan on doing some research. What you want to be looking at when you're considering a property is what kind of rents is that property going to bring in your market. You can go to HUD, Housing and Urban Development website. They've actually got some good information. You can pick up the brochures and the rental guides at the grocery store. You can look online. But you want to make sure what the rent is realistically going to be in the market in which you're thinking of purchasing a home. But the rents are only one small part of the equation. The other part of the equation is expenses. Now, in the expenses, you're going to have something called PITI. It stands for payment, interest, taxes, and insurance. If you purchased a home, you probably heard that term before. But the payment obviously consists of not only the interest you pay on the borrowed money, assuming you're borrowing money on the property, which most people do, but also on a partial pay down of the principal of the loan each month. On a 30-year loan, when you start making a payment, the amount that goes to principal is extremely small and the amount that goes to interest is extremely large. And as you go through your payment period, that starts to switch. Actually, you're going to pay more on interest than you do on principal for approximately 22 years of a 30-year mortgage. But some of the other things you're going to need to be aware of are your taxes and insurance. Now, taxes generally go one direction but up. In today's market, things have actually come down a little bit as far as values, but all the government has done, they're not really getting by any less money. They simply raise the mill rate or raise the tax rate per thousand of assessed value. And you typically don't get a whole lot of a break in many cases. Insurance varies all over. Some parts of the country, like Florida, we've owned property in Florida, and after one of the hurricanes that went through many years ago, the insurance premiums quadrupled. So those are the types of things you can expect if you live in a market that has those types of risks. But insurance premiums have been going up because the insurance companies have taken major losses over the years. So even in a place like Wisconsin, Nevada, which aren't real prone to natural disasters, you still are going to see your premiums are going up, and you got to be aware of that. Also, if you're buying a property where you pay the utilities, that can get to be a pretty big number. You can call the utility company. They'll give you the monthly average, the high, the low, what the building has averaged. But my advice is if you're buying a property as a new investor, try to buy a property, especially if it's a two-unit or above, where the utilities are divided so that you can let the tenants pay for their own utilities. You will find that the tenants use a whole lot less utilities when they're paying for it versus you paying for it. I used to have some older homes with one furnace, duplexes, twindos, and I'd drive by in the winter. The lower unit would, you know, have the heat cranked up, and the upper unit would be so hot they'd have the windows open. So literally, your money's going right out the window. Also, you got to be aware that a lot of municipalities have permits and licensing requirements. You need to make sure that the property you're buying, if it's not a single family, if it's multifamily, is actually licensed or allowed in the area in which you're doing. A lot of times people will convert their properties illegally into multifamily, and if you buy it, it's now your problem and you're going to have to make it right. In addition, you've got to add in vacancy. The problem is a lot of people think they're going to always have a tenant. That's not going to be the case. There are going to be months where there's vacancy. And I always use 10% because 10% is pretty safe unless you're in a real soft market. You're better off to use 10% and find it's only 5% than to do the opposite and find out that you're actually losing a lot of money. But the name of the game on real estate investment is cash flow. If you don't have cash flow, you are going to be in big trouble. When the market was really hot, people were buying and the payment was actually more than they were bringing in rent, but they were relying on the appreciation. And we'll eventually see some appreciation. In fact, some areas of the country are already going up strongly. Some areas in Florida, some areas in Nevada, Washington, D.C., a lot of these areas have actually started to rise quite nicely, including Texas. But cash flow is the name of the game. After all the bills are paid, after you've allowed for vacancy, your permits, everything, you need money coming in every month if you want to be successful in the long-term investor game. What it comes down to is mindset. You're going to have to have the right mindset to deal with tenants. Now, a lot of people, when they buy their first properties, really don't want to deal with tenants. They just want to take advantage of the income potential of rental real estate. They also want to take advantage of the depreciation, things of that nature. But ultimately, you're going to deal with tenants unless you hire professional management. Now, if you're just starting out, I'm going to recommend you do have plan the first year or two to manage your own properties. If you don't manage your own properties, you can't know when somebody else is doing a good job or a bad job. Now, when you deal with tenants, we're going to do a separate video on tenants, so you'll want to watch that. But when you're dealing with tenants, just be aware of that there are a lot of laws, rules, regulations that you absolutely need to follow if you don't want to have an enormous amount of trouble. But you want to manage your tenants properly, and if you do so and you stay on top of them, you're going to be just fine. Management, after you get enough properties, as you grow, a lot of people will use a management company to manage it. If you're going to use a management company to manage it, you really need to put that into your expenses, because management companies, depending on the size, if you have a 200-unit apartment complex, you might get by for 3 or 4% on a management fee. If you have a single family home that you want somebody to manage, they may charge you 10 to 12% of the gross, and they may even charge you extra for finding a tenant. But management is nice. A lot of people say they don't want to be fixing toilets in the middle of the night. Well, if you're worried about any of that, then you get a management company. But ultimately, if you want to be successful in real estate, my advice is to get a coach. We do coaching. There's also a lot of other coaches. We focus primarily on new investors, because we can handhold them through the process. But coaching is important if you want to get off on a good start, because real estate can be a great investment, but if you make a mistake, buy it wrong, and you have no cash flow, it's really going to be a miserable experience. So thank you for watching. If you'd like more information, you can go to our blog at madisonhomesales.com. madisonhomesales.com. You can also reach us at thehouseflipguru.com. and homewithtom.com. We are all over the web. You can Google our name and we will pop up. Contact us. We'll be happy to tell you how we can help you buy your first investment property successfully. Thanks, and have a great day.